Yeah, as an improviser mostly. I could play it, yeah.
Why not? What did you do on this?
Well, it was nice playing with Rob, because I just played him. Well, I played as much of the tune accompaniments as I wanted to, but mostly I did what I wanted. I didn't rehearse with them. I played with several bands. I used to play with the Acme Sewage Company as well.
But is this documented on records?
There are some tapes of the Acme Sewage Company. My son was the drummer in it, but there's only one record. There are tapes, I know. In fact, there was a great player in the Gas called Lou, just called himself L-U, Lou. And he's really knowledgeable about all kinds of music, and he'd turn up with some enormous stringed metal instrument on gigs and play really good free improvisations. I'll let this go. Yeah, do you know him, Lou Edmonds?
Yeah.
He's nice.
Yeah, he's really nice.
He knows so many different musics.
Yeah.
He's on this double album thing.
Yeah.
Just a little bit. With a huge, like an enormous banjo. It's about this big. Sounds great. Really loud and twangy.
What about being a musician like you nowadays in Britain? Is it easier than, for example, in the 60s, 50s? Is it more complicated?
Don't make very much money.
There's
so many good players in England. In terms of playing, it's great. Living in London, I mean, a lot of my favourite players live in London, and most of the others come there. So, have I played with you in London yet? I haven't. I've done it already.
I would
do sometime, and you're bound to. So it's great. You don't make any money. I mean, you might do a festival or some big concert, but a lot of people who really love the music just hire rooms in pubs, which you can just do in London.
Yeah.
And they pay them about £30, and any money that's left after all the expenses, they give to the musicians. But it's usually guaranteed that if you want to make money in London, you mustn't do too many gigs. If you become too familiar, then that you lose your credibility as a marketable person.
But Evan is playing a lot.
Evan does, but not as much as the rest of us. He doesn't do the London pub gigs very often, but he still does them anyway.
Yeah.
But I think Evan makes more money either out of the country or in things that we might not even hear about.
Yeah.
You know, like that aren't from the jazz scene, more from the cultural.
Yeah.
This is what I think. I don't know. Yeah. So. Playing is no problem, but
surviving.
It's just getting some money for it, but that's all right. I think on London gigs by the end of the year, I might just break even, but generally I've actually lost some money. But I've been, you're playing sometimes play to 8 people, aren't you, in London? You might be playing with some of the best players in the world to 8 people who just happened to be in London. They wanted to come over, phone around. But this is particularly an improviser's thing, isn't it?
Yeah, really.
It's not a general jazz thing at all. Very few people who do that. And so some of the really famous improvisers, if they're playing somewhere in England, they might just turn up and come and play at the pub. Nobody knows they're going to. Not very often, but it does happen. Especially the European people,
the
Dutch guys and people, they'll come over.
The official jazz scene in London is quite,
that's pretty tight.
Yeah.
I don't often play in, well, if you think of improvisation clubs as that rather than jazz clubs, I don't often play in jazz clubs in England.
Yeah.
In fact, I don't often play in jazz clubs at all.
Yeah.
I get the improvised clubs around the world.
So like the Ronnie Scott?
I never played at Ronnie's. Yeah. I played at his old place.
Yeah.
They used to let me go in there if I wanted to when I was busking and play in between the sets and hang out and get into the gigs free. It was nice.
You did so many collaborations during your career. Are there some wishes left? Are there some people you still want to play with and you haven't played with?
I suppose I can't think offhand. I'm interested in playing with anyone good where I think I can do something.
Any special names in your head?
Probably the people who I would be happy to play with wouldn't be likely to ask me to play with them because of the different angle that I go at.
Yeah.
I would like to play with Ornette. He's a very nice man. I think I could play all right with him. I probably couldn't play half of his tunes, but if we just improvised, I think I'd like it. And he's been very nice to me, you know. He asked me what my name was once.
But you did not play with him.
I told him Dorothy Lenore. No, I didn't. But I think that it could happen. He does think I'm all right, you know. I mean, he thinks... He understands what I'm trying to do and accepts me, you know. And other people in the band have been nice to me, so... But it probably won't. It could just happen by chance. But it wouldn't be likely to happen by arrangement.
And this new project you're doing, the one Wyatt?
I'm not doing a project with... Oh, no, I'm... you mean Soup Songs?
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's not a project I'm involved in. I'm a dep.
Yeah.
I stand in for someone. Didier Malherbe, Blue Dido Bad de Grasse, is the regular guy who I replace. And Larry's... And he's great because he plays so many instruments. It's much better having him. But when I do play, it does work, and it's nice. You know, I don't want to do it too often. And then... another one was George Kahn, and when he doesn't do it, Larry Sabbins does. Yeah. But I think George won't be doing so many now, so I imagine Larry is probably in the band. But I'm Didier's first replacement.